Yeah, and if we have a look, yeah, these are 20 countries global. From May 2010, the development of these tablet PCs. And this is the world without the US market. If you count all together, you will succeed to more than 2 million, 2.3 million tablet PCs which have been sold outside the US. And why do I point outside of the US? In the US market, where this product has started in 2010, around about 10 million tablet PCs have been sold in 2010. Yeah? And we see it is on a very early stage, in a very early phase of this market. This is the total sales until January 2011 outside the US, and we see Germany is the most important market for tablet PC, Japan, but less than the German market. We see Australia even also quite good. But all of these other countries, a lot of countries, are in the very early phase of developing this market. Yeah, so here we see, of course, a strong development. This will be the market of the future. Tablet PC will be an exciting market 2011 and beyond. So coming back to this one, we have seen the tablet PC has arrived. 2011 will be, on the other hand, the year of the smartphone. Smartphone in 2011 expected to be 16% of the market. But we see one important market is, of course, the TV. Yeah, and the origin of IFA is at least even also a long tradition in what has happened in TV market. The switch over from black and white TV to the colored TV, the switch over from analog broadcasting to digital broadcasting, and now the development of 3D. In 2011, we expect 250 million TV sets to be sold worldwide. 2011 will show a stabilization of this exciting market development of TV. 250 million worldwide, another growth in 2012 even to be developed. And if we say from 2010 to 2011 a stabilization of this market, why is this a stabilization? Because we have seen on one hand in 2010 this strong eco program which has started in Japan, and this additional volumes we have found in Japan will not be in 2011. But on the other hand, and this is much more important, we see on this chart the speed of innovation. So the old technology, CRT TV, going down in 2010 from 45 million in 2011, 27 million units only, go down so fast that at least the flat TV market cannot totally compensate this decrease of the CRT TV market. 250 million TV sets to be sold in the year 2011. And even also here we see, we switch over now to the pure LCD TV market. LCD TV market is positive, at least in all regions. By far the biggest market for LCD TV sets is the European region and the Asia-Pacific region. Asia-Pacific, of course, influenced by the development we find in China at the moment, and Asia-Pacific influenced at least even also by a strong development we find in India at the moment. But even also in all other countries, Middle East, Africa, the market is booming. South America, the market is booming. Yeah. North America, where we have at least a very high penetration of a flat TV, we find more or less a stabilization of this flat TV market. But Europe is still on growing by the chance of, driven by the development from analog broadcasting to digital broadcasting, driven by a development to bigger screen sizes, and at least driven by the development of a new technology, which is at least 3D. Yeah, we expect worldwide 2011 12 million 3D TV sets which will be sold. 12 million, in Europe it will be 4.5 million 3D TV sets. It is an exciting market, it is an exciting experience for the consumers, it is an exciting challenge, at least for the retailers, to bring this experience to the consumers. But there is more innovation in the TV market. internet has arrived in the living room. Now everyone will say, but internet in the living room, this is nothing new. If I tell to my daughter, she's 14 years old, the internet has arrived in the living room, I will say, hey daddy, internet has arrived in the living room since 2 or 3 years, but how has internet arrived in the living room up to now? And this is a survey GfK has done in May 2010. Yeah, a lot of people agreed, yeah, do you use internet while you are watching TV? Yeah, and more than 50% say yes, often, or yes, but not so often, but they go into the internet while they are watching TV. I know this from my daughter, sitting on the sofa in the living room, watching Germany's Next Top Model, what else? Yeah, and then having the laptop on the knees and chatting with the girlfriends. Yeah, so at the moment in the living room is with internet. Internet has reached the living room, but with a separate device. Yeah, and we see, yeah, 42% of those people who have agreed that they use internet in the living room while watching TV do this at least with a non-portable computer, or 63% at least with a notebook. They do it with a different device. Only 2% up to now do this with the TV set. And this is at least the challenge for the future, that as soon as the TV set is connected to the internet, with the TV set they will go to Facebook. With the TV set they will go to YouTube and have all these movies, not on a small screen, not on a 12-inch screen or even 9-inch screen only, but on a 50-inch screen or even above that. This brings in total the conclusion, the technical markets continue to grow. We expect a positive development in 2011, and we expect at least even also a positive development in 2012. Europe is number one region in terms of revenue. Even, of course, a lot of exciting things happens even also in other regions. In the US, the upcoming market of tablet PCs, yeah, we see at least even also the 30% growing market in India with the smartphones. So it is all over the world, step by step, a growing market. The earthquake in Japan will have a limited impact on global markets. Yes, it attacks, of course, at the moment the Japanese market. Yeah? But even with the situation of a dramatic earthquake in Japan, the total market will continue to grow in 2011 and 2012. And a main point of development is, on one hand, the connectivity of the products. All products, step by step, will be linked to the internet. Not only the PC, not only the mobile phone. In the future, more and more often, at least, even also the TV. The Blu-ray player is linked to the internet by BD Live. And why not in the future, at least, even also the fridge, the cooking field, the washing machine that you can watch on your tablet PC, is the washing program finished or is it not finished? So there are a lot of applications which are and will be available in the future via the internet. And the other hot issue for innovation is at least the energy efficiency. Yeah? All the discussions we have at the moment, yeah? Do we need nuclear power in the future? Do we not need nuclear power in the future? Is at least leading to the end that consumer has to decide where can they save energy. Yeah? And they will ask, they have asked this in the past before the major domestic appliances market, they will ask this at least even also in the consumer electronic market in the future. So this will be at least even also the other hot point for driving the market. And we have the development on retail side, and the most important development on retail side is the development of a new channel, internet sales, which have appeared in the market since 2 or 3 years and is now on a rather high level, different region by region. Internet sales, however, is not only that people buy this in the internet. Internet allows the consumer at least even also to have a very, very fast price transparency online, and they can check the prices very, very early. Yeah. They can have a look to the product via the internet, and this is something even the traditional retailer have to be aware even also, that he has not alone his shop, he is at least in competition to a lot of more channels, a lot of more prices than he has ever expected before. So far, development of the consumer electronic markets. I think we have a good chance, at least even also, to grow in the future. Thank you for auditing me, and hopefully we see us all in Berlin again. Thank you very much.